As part of our ongoing celebration of Title IX, many of the Lady Vol trailblazers equated this important legislation with opportunity. One of the all-time great Lady Vol basketball players agrees.
Title IX for me really gave me the opportunity. You know, I think about where would I have been as far as being able to come to the University of Tennessee. Where would I have been without the WNBA? And so just the opportunity that it afforded me as a student athlete, and even now as a professional on the other side, just all of the doors that have been opened over the years as we celebrate 50 years strong.
Tamika Catchings has won at every level of the game of basketball. As she reflects back on all that she has accomplished, she always pays honor to the people who challenged and cared for her along the way.
When I think about Pat and I think about her journey and the road that, the door she opened, the road that she was on, it allowed players like me to have someone like Pat. It allowed women's basketball to have the stage that it has. It allowed women, and her in particular, the opportunity to play and then coach. And so many amazing women that have come after her. That's what I think about.
And while Title IX was obviously important to women's collegiate athletics, it was the expectations of visionaries like Pat that propelled the Lady Vol family.
Greatness. When you think about one word, I think that sums up what being a Lady Vol is. It's just greatness. And not solely greatness on the basketball court, but greatness in, as far as the person, greatness as far as the expectation that Pat had for in the community, in the classroom, on the basketball court. And I always say, she didn't want us to just be great in those areas. She wanted us to be great people. And so when I think about culture and I think about what it means, what it stands for, when we come back and we have our Lady Vol reunion, it's really about being around people that just, they embody what Pat wanted, which was for us to be great in our own individual way, that collectively we all are great.
50 years is essentially two generations. Tamika is very proud that kids can continue to dream and strive for things that weren't possible before Title IX.
You know, I think it's cool when you start looking at just women's sports in general. You know, I can go back to when my mom and my grandma, and, you know, had the opportunity maybe to be around sports, but not necessarily to play. Now you're kind of shifting into that gear where now it's a part of our norm. You know, get outside and go play a sport. It doesn't matter what sport, just get outside. And it really is becoming a norm of seeing young girls, seeing teenagers, seeing women perform and perform at a high level. The WNBA, I mean, I go back to year one, two, three when people were like, oh, the WNBA won't make it past year five. And we did. Year 10, and we did. Year 15, and we did. Year 20, and we're still here. And I think having leagues like the WNBA, having our women's professional soccer, having the USA basketball and USA program, sports program for women that we have, that's important for these young girls to continue to see, and as a society, for us to adapt. Like, this is here to stay, and women's sports is really important for all of us.
And as that work continues, here's to the next 50 years of supporting all the future Tamika Catchings that are waiting to show their talent now that they have the opportunity to do so. Stay tuned this Thursday for our final panel discussion as our guests talk about their coach, mentor, and friend, Pat Summitt.